Let's open the week in corporate stories. The Philippine government awards to ICSTI a 25-year contract to develop and operate a commercial port in Western Visayas. The Iloilo Port Complex has 20 hectares of land for container and general cargo storage. Enrique Razon's ICSTI vows to improve terminal productivity and service quality by developing its infrastructure and investing in cargo handling equipment. The port's giant assumes operations of the facility today after securing the notice to proceed from the port's authority. Now, the FirstGen Corporation, it announced the awarding of its LNG cargo tender to a subsidiary of China National Offshore Oil Corporation. The cargo supply of some 130,000 cubic meters of liquefied natural gas will be delivered in May by CNOOC to FirstGen's LNG tanker in Batangas. And finally, 2023 earnings from PTNT. The telco service provider returns to profitability after its net income last year reversed 10 billion pesos in capital deficiency. The company put the growth in net income at 155%. But did not disclose the figure. PTNT also confirms it's eyeing to resume trading at the Philippine Stock Exchange after a two-decade hiatus. It says PSE has acknowledged it's no longer in the red, but adds some items remain unaddressed in its rehabilitation plan.
Today is the last day of filing the annual income tax returns. Let's get an update on that from Jackie Pascual, who now joins us on the line at the BIR office in Makati. Jackie, go ahead.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. The Bureau of Internal Revenue expects around 200,000 people to file their annual income tax return on the last day of filing, which is today. BIR Commissioner Romeo Lumagi Jr. inspected some revenue district offices in Metro Manila, and he said so far there have been no major complaints or reports of any untoward incident. The news team also checked the BIR Revenue Region 8B South NCR office in Makati, and there were several empty chairs. The BIR compound even was decorated with summer vacation-themed designs like surfboards, umbrellas, and any beach designs to entice more people to file their ITR and pay taxes. And Stanley, there was also free food given to the filers. Lumagi explains that majority already filed early and many filed online. About 60 to 70% of filers, he said, use the electronic forms on the BIR website, and only 30 to 40% are manual filers. Lumagi is confident the Bureau will hit the tax collection target this year of 3.055 trillion pesos. That's despite not hitting its target last year. Tax collection in 2023 grew to 2.5 trillion pesos, but just shy of its target of 2.67 trillion pesos. But so far, Lumagi said tax collection for the first 2 months of the year is above its target, and they hope to continue that till the end of the year. And that's the latest, Stanley. Back to you.
Thank you so much, Jackie Pascual.